Matador, 2005. Yes, yeah, starring Pierce Brosnan and Greg Kinnear. I remember this movie because it was so, like, the previews and trailers came back in the early 2000s, and I remember seeing Pierce Brosnan in a comedic role. And I said, this is the first time he was doing this since GoldenEye and all that. He just got out of that, I believe, that series, playing that of James Bond role, and he comes into the Matador. So it's really a black and white here kind of contrast part for me to see him in as a comedian. And it was funny. He's a funny man. There's no doubt about it when he wants to be. We've seen this before, and I just love Pierce doing the comedic parts. How could you not? Because he's so serious. He has this serious look on his face. So when he says something that's funny, you know, it's funny. Even if it's not funny, you know, the way he brings his mannerisms and his body language, and as well as how he says things, really a comedic movie here. Now, listen, the story is not something that is epic or, you know, a comedic legend movie. I'm not saying that, but The Matador, of course, you got Greg Kinnear, who always plays that anxiety-ridden, stressful guy pretty well. But the story basically is this hitman here who comes to live with Greg Kinnear, stay with him, and he opens his world to things like that. So when Pierce stays with him, you know, it's a different kind of lifestyle, different kind of way of living. They get together, and the chemistry is there. I feel like there's chemistry, but there could have been more to the movie, of course. There could have been funnier parts. I think a different writer of The Matador with definitely more comedic bits and jokes would have paid off. And a little sarcastic, more humor. I would have liked that in The Matador. But I do like Pierce. He does carry this movie, guys, all the way. If you love you some Pierce Brosnan, check this movie out. It might surprise you. The Matador, to see him just Matador and Greg Kinnear and everybody else around. Yeah!